journal entry of salary. So before we go further, we have to understand what are assets and what are liabilities. So assets are future economic benefits, the right of which are owned or controlled by an organization or individual. Means its benefit can be derived in future. Similarly, what are liabilities? Liabilities are those which are to be paid in near future. So in this entry we will have to understand assets and liability first. And here, like, if we have to add assets in our business, we have to debit it. Similarly, if we have to show liabilities, then we have to credit it. On the other hand, if we have to reduce assets, then we have to credit it, and if we have to reduce liabilities, we have to debit it. Now, when we will make the journal entry of salary, like salary is an expense for us, so when salary is paid 10,000, the entry is simple: salary account debit to cash account, where salary is an expense and cash is going out of business. In the next entry, the salary paid 5,000, actual salary 10,000. In this entry, salary is an expense, but in this case we are just paying 5,000. The salary which is not paid is an outstanding salary and it is a liability for the firm, and it is credited here. So the entry will be salary account, we have to debit it with the 10,000 as the cash is going only 5,000, and the remaining salary is the outstanding salary, and we have to show that salary also. This is our last entry, where salary paid 15,000, actual salary 10,000. Here the salary has paid in advance. The salary which is paid in advance is an asset for the firm. So which is paid in advance, it's a prepaid salary. And here the salary entry will be like, we have to write down the salary 10,000, and we have to even write the prepaid salary which is 5,000, and we have to pay cash 15,000. So that's the way we will make the entries of salary, and in the next part we will learn how to make them adjust in the next month. That's all. Thank you.